Good morning, crafty friends. Sparkle here. Today I'm just doing a little flip through of what I'm calling an envelope stack with a twist. First of all, I revisited these little envelopes, and I decided I'm just going to leave this one as it is. I still have to ink them and maybe put some embellishments, but these are with the fronts on top glued down, and I think I'll just use this as a focal point on top of a journal. And then I took some more of the envelopes, and this time I did them face up. They still need to be decorated, but now I can put stuff in the pockets. So when you flip it, you know, you can now fill the pockets. Okay? So this was I wanted a fifth one, so this was just on my desk. It's a coin envelope, but, you know, if this is all blinged out and stuff, it would work. So this is number two. But what I wanted to show you today was something I worked on yesterday, and this is just going to be a flip through. And then if you're interested, you need to comment below, and I'll do a full video. Okay, it'll probably have to come in several parts. But I've seen similar. I still want to work with my envelopes, you know. So what I did was, and like I said, these envelopes I had already showed you previously. I had already put them all down, and I just covered them from being assembled. Okay, but I learned some tricks I want to show you. So, and I used some of my stickers from the Dollar Tree. I thought they looked cute in here. And this was some paper from Rach and Bella. I'll have to get the kit, but it's all ledgers and antique stuff. So I just put these stickers on here. So what you do is, your envelopes all go onto a base, and I'll show you. And I line them with some medical tape, and I'll show you that. Now, it's going to hold tags, which I did not put in yet. Okay, this one's here. This one's here. So they're all pockets. Okay? So I thought this in itself was cute. But then I decided to... I had this book cover on my desk from that paper I bought at the Dollar Tree. So I just mounted that to the cover, lined it, and just put one signature in. And again, it's not decorated much. Here's some of my bird pictures that I got the other day, my bird paper. This is the paper that the cover was wrapped in. This was a blunder. I have my music paper upside down, so. And this, I like these little corner things that I like to make. It's just a 4-inch square, and then I lined it with some just typing paper. So like a little journal, and I just put a paper clip to hold it. But again, this isn't decorated. This is just my template. And then I just have the strings tied, and I put some beads on the bottom. I just tied some beads on there. I just put glue on my fingers and made these pointy so I could feed my buttons. So that's the book. If you want a tutorial on that, just let me know below. But I'll show you what we used. So you get your envelopes, and I need to black this out before I work to publish anything, of course, but I'm not worried about it because it's not going to sit there too long. And that one had way too many envelopes. I like to do like maybe 6. So I like a base, and then you want envelopes with flaps. Okay, you'll have flaps. This one did not. Okay, the flap was closed, so you can make a flap. So if you have an envelope That doesn't have it working flat, like this one. Simply take a piece of paper, this is cardstock, and I think it's 2 inches, and oops, try to get them even. That's okay for this. And I'm going to miter the corners. I'll do the other one when it's on. Then put it on here, and whatever side you want the flap on, side want it on here. So you're just going to glue this down, and that will make your flap. So I've learned to, most of my envelopes now I'm cutting on the end opposite the window. I'm usually cutting them up here to open them. This wasn't a good example. So I usually, but sometimes, so the flaps are sealed, but you can just do this. Make a flap. Might have to trim it a little bit. And, of course, put it on straight. So once you get it on straight, and disregard the tear I just did, but now you have a base. So you want to put them on here. But before you do that, I took some of this tape and I ran it down my seam. You could use washi tape, but that's a little thin. So or if you have a different medical tape. This is a little thinner. And you just, because I found that this is going to get pretty much a lot of wear and tear on the sides. Okay. So, yeah, get that in there. Increase it real good. So, bad example. Bad example, Sparkle. So it's reinforced, okay? Don't worry about that. That's just a sample. But then they go like this. And I'm trying to just do 3 on each side because this one I had like 8 envelopes. But they were ready together, so I just went with it. So you're going to want to put one here and then different sizes. And it's okay that it's where it's cut because that's where my pocket will go. So you just want to wrap them so all these pieces are in the back. And maybe put this one in here and then this one in here. So I'm just going to go for 3 on each side. So all the backs are here. After they're all lined with the tape, then you can glue them down on top of each other. Okay? And again, I use this here base part to hold them. And then I'm going to put 3 on this side. So here again, here's one that I made a flap because it had no flap. So I'll put that there, and this one here, and you can scatter, they don't have to be even or anything. So again, all the backs are here after you glue them here. That is your base. But what I'll do is, after they're all in, I'll scatter them like this, alternate them. So when you're doing your paper, keep that in mind, okay? So this will be my next one. Now, then you would decide, I want to put a pocket here, so you'll take scissors and make a slit here and a punch. Okay, so maybe a side here. Maybe I want this one up here. assuming that there's no cuts here. Okay? But on this one, I might, it was okay to decorate while they were attached, but I might try decorating these without being attached. I'm not sure. And just leave a little margin so they turn. You know, and you'll play with it and you'll get a feel for what you want. Okay? And they don't have to be, you could use, you could cut one of these, fold one of these in half. Cut some of this off. And use these. As long as it has something in the back here to attach down. And again, make sure you reinforce. So, yeah. But that's too many. I only want six because it got out of hand. This one is heavy. Okay. And there's, oops. There's one, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three. I thought there was more. Be bad. It's just the way that I set these up because I already had these attached and I wouldn't have put this here. I would have put it on top or on the side. But that's okay. It's okay. So, yeah, and I decorated these while they were on here, okay? So, if you want to see that process, let me know. But that's some of the tricks that I learned that reinforce this part before you go any further. And you could ink now before you put your paper on. And then you'd probably need around, there's six pockets, you might need six pieces of designer paper. And yeah, this cuts much easier than other stuff that I was using. Yeah, and then just reinforce them. Because then this doesn't matter, this is all going to be glued down. That'll be reinforced. Okay? So try that and get this part made. And then you would find, have to find a base to put it on. Again, I have a book cover here I may or may not use. I would reinforce this real good. It doesn't have to go, it could go directly into a journal, you know, but I like putting it, making it onto the cover. So this one is kind of big, so I might, if I were to use this, I would cut these down, these big ones down a little bit. They'll still be bigger than these, but I would cut it down so they'd fit in here. Okay, and then I put my tie in here, and I taped it down, and so it could wrap over this. Okay, so that's the flip through. I hope you are inspired. I'll let you know again if I come up with anything for these. I like the idea, but my mind just isn't feeling it yet. So I'll keep revisiting it. But like I said, I wanted to use up these packets that I already had made of envelopes. Now this one will just be maybe like a signature. Maybe I'll do this as a signature in a book. Because this just has a couple. Okay, and they're all going on the right. So I might just take this into my book. Into an actual journal, and it could just be a flip through with pockets and tags. So these were not reinforced, but I will now reinforce them, right? as they are already done, I'll just put some tape over them. And then when you glue, you know, just glue around this. So they could be pockets. I'm not necessarily interested in, let's see, some of these. No, I think I glued mine down because I didn't want to do pockets in there. But, you know, you could leave this open and make it a pocket, but I just want the one pocket. So, yeah, I'll cut out some tags and make some tags for this. But I hope you were inspired. Thanks for looking, and I'll see you again real soon. Bye.